Hello, and welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan, and today we're going to be learning about how to classify aldoses and ketoses, which was something that you're going to find in introductory biochemistry. So with these are carbohydrates that have aldehyde and ketone groups. So whenever we are seeing an aldose, so for the first example all the way up top, you can see that we have the aldehyde, which is all the way on carbon number one for the first structure. So let's just write this one down here. And then for the ketone, we can see that on carbon number two, we always have our ketone with biomolecules. So we're going to go through step by step how we can actually classify these as aldoses, ketoses, what exactly are they, and how we can count the number of carbons in these different structures and how we can label them for your biochemistry course. Let's take a look at it. All right, so the first thing is when we are classifying carbohydrates, these are known as simple sugars because these are specifically monosaccharides. So whenever we have a monosaccharide, that means there is one single carbohydrate that we are showing. Now with most of these different carbohydrates, they have the ending of -ose. So whenever we see that -ose ending, that's telling you, hey, this is a sugar, this is a carbohydrate, being that it has the carbon chain, it has that aldehyde or ketone, and it has those alternating OHs that we will see in Fischer projections or Haworth projections to illustrate these. Let's take a look even farther into this. So when we are given a carbohydrate or a simple monosaccharide, the first step is that you have to identify the functional group, which is what you're going to, what you will receive training on how to do from your introductory organic class. So with this, what you're looking for is two major functional groups. These are aldehydes and ketones. So when we have our first one, so with our aldehyde, what's going to happen is we're going to take that ALD portion and put the -ose ending on it to make it an aldose. With ketose or ketone, we take ketone and then we transport that into ketose. Now, the reason why I highlighted these specific portions of the biochem is that when you actually classify these, you're going to use the aldo or keto to help explain exactly what kind of carbohydrate or simple sugar you are looking at. And always remember, the aldehyde or the aldose is always going to be on carbon number one, and the ketose will always be on carbon number two for our simple sugars. Let's go to step number two. Step two, now that we identified what functional group we have, we're now going to count the number of carbons. So there are generally, most of these simple carbohydrates go up to typically seven carbons most of the time. So if we have, let's say, three carbons, this is going to be a triose, so or triose. So think of the triangle, so triose. Now, when we have four, this is a tetrose. Five is pentose. Six is hexose. So for the next portion, we are going to combine step one and two, which being that we have the aldehyde and ketone from the first step, so we're going to take aldo or keto, depending on the functional group, and we're going to combine that with the number of carbons that we have. So if I have, let's say, the example here, what you're going to do is we're going to first do is identify the functional group. And what we can see up here is that, oh, well, we have an aldo or an aldehyde, okay? So that would be the first portion here. So let's write aldehyde is what we have as our functional group. So it's going to be aldo. Now, how many carbons does it have? So what we will do is we are going to number, right? We have one, two, three. We start the numbering all the way at the top of our Fischer projection. We number down. So start all the way as close to the most oxidized carbon as you can, so the aldehyde or the ketone. So now that we have three carbons, this is going to be an aldotriose as our classification for this structure, okay? So that is all you have to do is when you're classifying them. Let's go through a couple different examples and practice these different skills. Let's take a look. So with the following questions, we're going to classify the following carbohydrates. So we're going to go through our steps, right? Step one plus two, putting our two things together. So the very first step is that we need to count and classify what our functional group is. So on the structure on the left, we can see that, oh, we have an aldehyde, right? Because we are looking right here on carbon number one. We see that C double bond O. So that means that this will be an aldo. Now, how many carbons do we have? Well, we're going to go down our chain. We see we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbons on our structure. So now what is that going to be? Well, in this case, it's going to be an aldohexose for our title, right? So we can see we have hex for 6. So it's going to be aldohexose. So and that will be how we would classify the structure on the left. Now, what about the structure above? Well, same idea. We got to first identify what the functional group is. And when we go through numbering here, right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we can see that on carbon number 2, we have our carbonyl, right? So our C double bond O. So what that means is when we have that there, we have a keto. And being that there's 5 carbons, that's going to be keto pentose. Is going to be the name for that structure. Okay, or sorry, not name. It's going to be the classification for that structure. Let's take a look at another two examples and keep practicing. It's our last two. So if this is something that you want to practice, pause the video, see if you can do it for yourself before I go through the example. So we're going to start by numbering our carbons. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4. And we see that on our carbon number 2, we have a carbonyl, so that's C double bond O. That tells you, hey, we have a keto, right, or ketone. So it's going to be keto, and being that we have 4 of them, this is going to be keto tetrose for our classification. We're going to do the same thing on the next one, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And what we see is, oh, there's a C double bond O all the way up top. So this is going to be aldo and tose, being that there are 5. And that would be how you classify this one. I hope that this video helped. It's a little short one, just to go through the basics of how to classify carbohydrates. Look for my follow-up videos on how to draw Haworth projections, Fischer projections, and more to come with introductory biochem. If this video helped you, hit that like, subscribe button. Help support the channel. It keeps growing. And thank you so much for watching, and I appreciate you. Have a wonderful day. I'll see you all later. Bye now.